Kia ora nā, mālo e lele, and welcome to Tangata Pasifika.
E kumoi o mō, tā lofa on the show today. The digital library helping to educate our tamariki online.
The beauty of having a digital library is that you can access it anytime, anywhere.
We meet the family putting a spin on their laundry business.
Working with my siblings, it's a dream come true. I don't know how to explain it, but it's amazing, man.
And some of our opera OGs get together for a special show.
Just wrote it, and then they said, let's do a concert. Let's call it the OGs, which you get everyone together who started out in the 80s and 90s.
Maoruru. But first to health, and a Pasifika advocate welcomes government's plans to ban single-use vapes by the end of the year, but says more needs to be done. Currently, about 15% of 15 to 17-year-olds vape, with more than 1,500 specialist vape retailers around the country. Shops caught selling vapes to under-18s will also be fined a maximum penalty of up to $100,000. Tala Pasifika Director Ulungia Edward Cowley is worried about youth vaping rates and hopes it will be closely monitored.
When we look at the new fines that are coming in from $10,000 to $100,000, that's incredible in terms of, you know, having fines. Who's going to enforce this and make sure that it actually happens? It's all very well to have a new law, but unless you've got people on the ground monitoring it, making sure that it's happening and prosecuting, then actually it could be quite empty.
To sport now, and some of our legendary Pacific Islands rugby players will be formally inducted into the inaugural Pasifika Rugby Hall of Fame at Auckland's Eden Park next week. This will be one of several events in a celebration of Pasifika Rugby, which includes the awards dinner and a game day breakfast on Saturday. A special Pacific Islands festival will be held at Eden Park that day, and the build-up to Moana Pasifika taking on the Blues later that night. Get along and support them.
That's fantastic. And finally, the annual ASB Polyfest kicked off in Auckland this week for its 49th year. Students from Auckland Secondary School showcased their Māori and Pacific Islands culture on stage, while also highlighting the growing ethnic diversity in our schools. The theme this year is Meanga Whakamuri Kia Ko Ke Whakamua, looking to our past to determine our future. Today's the last day of the festival, so why not head over to the event in Manukau or watch online. Just go to the ASB Polyfest website for the details. Ah, minaka. And also happening today is the Moananui Pacific Festival in Dunedin, and also the Rotorua Pasifika Festival.
Sounds
as well.
Like lots of fun. Well, to our first story now, and we've heard of them before, the trio of mums who are taking teachings from the village of the hub of technology for our future generations.
Yes, that's right. Evo, Teresa and Tatiana are taking their online platform Pacific Kids Learning to another level with the launch of their new project, the Pacific Digital Library. Hanalei Te Mese Foliaki has the story.
Traditional teachings transformed into technology. Mums Evor, Teresa and Tatiana are the creators of Pacific Kids Learning, an online platform dedicated to preserving and promoting Pacific culture through the education of our kids.
I created Pacific Kids Learning some time ago, 2014, when we had our second child. We now have five. So they're the direct inspiration for the creation of PKL. As a mother, when you're kind of trying to juggle things at home, you know, washing the dishes and getting dinner ready. So quite naturally, I'd plonk my children in front of YouTube. And there was just absolutely nothing in the Pacific languages.
Identifying that with a desire to fill the gap, Evel brought together a small team of mums to bring the passion project to life.
The three of us have come together through Evel. Evel and I met in South Korea, of all places. So she's from Otara, I'm from Mangere, and when our paths crossed in South Korea, instantly we had that connection. Her and Tatiana know each other through university, and now we're three mums leading Pacific Kids Learning.
Evel reached out to me and asked if I wanted to be part of Pacific Kids Learning, when we wanted to take it to the next level, and she wanted the finance background. So I've always believed in PKL from the very beginning, so I was happy to jump on board back then.
The online learning hub already hosts a wide range of resources for children to engage with, including heritage storytelling by local students through the medium of animation, as well as their Pacific Digital Dance project using 3D motion capture to map Pacific Island Seba. But it's the launch of their newest concept, the Pacific Digital Library Project, that's bringing it all together.
Our kids are engaged in all sorts of digital spaces, right? From Netflix to Disney to even, you know, gaming on PlayStation or Xbox. So it's actually been a scope of research in terms of seeing how our kids engage. So with our PDL or our Pacific Digital Library, it's making sure that those same elements are still there.
I think the beauty of having a digital library is that you can access it anytime, anywhere. Especially us being working mums, we can kind of attest to how challenging it is to, you know, schedule everything and especially cultural learning.
I've got a lifelong connection through my two beautiful children to Tonga. They whakapapa back to Hawakatolo and Hofoa in Tongatapu. We were living in Tonga when my youngest was a baby. She came back to New Zealand speaking Tongan. Now, like 3 years later, she's lost it. And I think if we had had content back then that we've created now, it might have just helped to keep that in her everyday language, her everyday life.
The trio's hopes are high, marrying technology with tradition, even if it means that the cost might be a factor.
Obviously, it's been a great help to have support from the ministry, support from Creative New Zealand, but we're at that time now where we need to be a sustainable business and not so reliant on the government. What's linked to that challenge is to get mainstream to value the knowledge that we have to share. It's actually for everybody who wants to learn more about the Pacific, who wants to increase their cultural intelligence. If you want to learn about the Pacific, the Indigenous knowledge of our elders and our village is encompassed within the library.
Fantastic. Congratulations, and do check it out. Now stay with us when we come back, giving the laundromat the Pasifika makeover.
But next, the home ownership dream becomes a reality for one Pasifika family.
It's been a transformational journey for us to own our own home. So stepping into our place is like, you know, feel like we belong.
Pacifica, born a people proud, people of the sun. homebound. Tagata Pasifika, born a people proud.
Welcome back to Tagata Pasifika. Owning your own home is a dream for many Pacific Islands families, and for the Havilis, it is one that they have realised thanks to a shared home ownership scheme run in East Auckland.
That's right, that initiative is run by the Tamaki Regeneration Company, which is replacing some 2,500 state homes in Glen Innes, Panmure and Point England with 10,500 new warm high quality homes, some to be returned as social housing with others available to buy. Here's John with the story.
East Auckland is home sweet home for the Havili family.
It's been a transformational journey for us to own our own home. So stepping into our place is like, you know, feel like we belong. And you know, we have a connection to the whenua and be part of Aotearoa.
After years of renting and staying with family, the Havilis are now on the property ladder.
We both grew up in Tonga and migrated here to study. And part of that dream was, you know, study, get a job, and then, you know, buy your own home. But for us, like after finding a job and looking at the price of buy your own home, it was getting impossible, and you know that dream was keep getting further away for us.
But starting off fresh with a young family has its challenges.
The life during that time was really hard because, you know, being the only person to work and provide for the family, plus the rental was a bit too expensive for us at the time.
You guys did all the hard work, you know, just, you know, and I've said this to you guys before, yeah, that, you know, we've extremely proud of your journey.
So their pathway to home ownership began in 2020 during the lockdown. Mele and Samisoni took part in an online program run by the Tamaki Regeneration Company.
Tamaki Regeneration Company was set up just over 10 years ago to undertake what we call urban regeneration in this area of Tamaki Makaurau. So it includes Glen Innes, Panmure and Point England.
They completed the 8-week program known as Own It, set up to help families get one step closer to owning their very own place.
What they covered in that workshop is different ways of how to save money, and then also raise awareness about banking system, and then, you know, talk about interest rate, talk about Reserve Bank and the inflation and all those stuff. You heard about it, but you never take the time to slow down and research what they were actually talking about.
After that, like, you know, we secure a pre-approved loan, and then, we did the handover and they give us the key and then welcome us into our home. So for us, we thought it's going to be very complicated, But they did a lot of the mahi to support us in that journey and kind of give us the courage to keep pushing through. You know, it's going to happen.
Another who has signed up for the program is Auckland City Councillor and local resident Josephine Bartley, who's keen to remain in the neighbourhood.
We know that with our families, very hard to have any capital or, you know, deposit to get you on the first stage of buying a home. So you really need programs that understand that and cater to it. You know, we have good income coming in, it's just nobody's got 50 grand ready to go. So I see the benefits of what Tamaki Regeneration are doing, and I just hope we continue to cater it to the reality of our families.
From two-bedroom apartments to large standalone homes, the Own It program is helping to unlock the hurdles of home buying.
Typically a whānau will come up with 70% of the value of the home. That includes a mortgage and potentially some savings that they've got, either through KiwiSaver or through personal savings. And then they come to us and say, yep, we've got our bit. And we'll say, well, we've got our bit, which is the house, and we'll hold on to the other 30% and give them 20 years, a 20-year period to pay us out.
Since 2017, more than 90 families on the Own It program have been able to own their own home, with many more homeowners on the way. Another local and first home buyer, Selina Patia, is now the one welcoming families into their new house.
So this is what the family will come into and have a look, and live in. So they'll make the space as their own and put all the stuff they need in here. It's really a heartwarming journey for me, also very humbling, because I know the work that a lot of our families put into becoming mortgage ready, being able to get into these homes, buying their first home. So it's very exciting. I'm still pinching myself every now and again.
What was a dream is now reality for the Havili family, and they hope many more will be able to follow them.
Don't be scared to look for help. That's the only word that I'm saying. That if we can do it ourselves, because we grew up in Tonga and come here, and now we're spreading the words for our people. If we can do it, then anyone can do it.
Congratulations.
All right, after the break, we meet some of our OG opera singers.
But next, the Samoan family putting their own spin on the laundry business.
I think just changing the whole look, adding a uniform to the laundry place, you know, adding, intertwining fashion and the laundry industry together, which brings in obviously a younger audience, a creative audience.
Just
Malo ni and welcome back to Tagata Pasifika. Well, if you're one of those people who like to pile up a week's laundry in the corner and hope for it to disappear, then this next story is for both of us.
Well, that's right. Samoan brothers Esther and Filoa McCarthy decided to do something about it. And as reporter Niueli Moafu found out, sometimes all it takes to start up a business is a bit of faith and family love.
It's a task most people avoid or forget to do.
No one loves doing laundry. Everyone has that one big chair at the house where they just load everything on the chair and then wait till it's the last minute to do all the laundry.
That's Esther McCarthy, who along with brother Filoa have brought a new spin to the world of laundromats with their mobile laundry service called Launda Limited.
A lot of the people who own laundromats don't look like islanders, and they don't have tattoos all over their face or like all over their bodies.
There's something in the way of us being in the shop and outsiders looking in. I think just changing the whole look, adding a uniform to the laundry place, they're adding intertwining fashion and the laundry industry together, which brings in obviously a younger audience, a creative audience.
Inside, you won't find your regular staff because over here, family is everything.
Working with my siblings, it's a dream come true. I don't know how to explain it, but it's amazing, man. You can't just get a friend in here. You gotta have your own blood, you know. We've been through some wars together. We've been hungry together. We slept on kitchen floors. Struggle made us close. We grew up with nothing, which is why we are all in here, because we know what it's like to come from nothing.
I think the values that I saw from my parents is integrity, loyalty, and hospitality. And the cool thing about this is that I get to do it with my family.
The family business follows a simple rule: wash, dry, fold, relax, focusing on giving the customers a break from the hassle of their daily lives.
Me as an operations manager, I try to find the fastest but quality times. At the same time, find out how to push out our customers and clients' laundry in the right time. Try and make sure everything's in place, everything's here, everything's there, make sure our delivery's on time.
We want to give people their time back. Time to spend with your family, time to, whether it's like 40 bucks, 50 bucks, that shouldn't be the value of your time. The value of your time is, once your time's gone, it's gone.
For now, Launda Limited currently operates from their laundromat in Penmure, with big plans and dreams for the future.
Launda facilities everywhere in Auckland. Launda vans posted everywhere in Auckland. That's what I'm looking forward to.
We're just excited to launch. We haven't launched anything. Right now we've only got commercial clients, but our residential customer-based clients will soon open. People will always have perceptions on how they see you, but your actions will always speak louder than words.
Shout out to your mom and dad. Hi, mom and dad. I love you guys. I promise you guys, we will give you the life you truly deserve. God's good.
Amen.
Oh, beautiful. Well done, boys. John will be over soon with
yes,
his laundry.
Yes, absolutely. Now to the arts now, and if you're wanting a fun-filled night of music entertainment, why not try the Pasifika Opera, paying tribute to the OGs of the genre.
Now, it's part of the Auckland Arts Festival, a cast of Pasifika Opera greats. They're performing in a special one-off show tomorrow afternoon. Soana Ahulele caught up with them for this story.
What do you get when you have a tenor, a bass baritone and a soprano in a room? A Pasifika masterpiece.
As an OG.
It's thanks to composer, director and tenor Selinga Sani Muliamau Se'ali'i for creating this Pasifika opera.
Just wrote it, and then I said, let's do a concert. Let's call it the OGs, which you get everyone together who started out in the 80s and 90s before we get to the end of our careers and just do something here in Aotearoa. I just said, let's do it. Are you free? And they said, yeah, so they came.
The operatic giants featuring in the show are a mix of cultures and a lot of personality.
Deborah Waikapohe is our tangata whenua. So we base everything, we start the show with her. Is it a show? We start the creationship with her and we end with her. Aivale I've worked with in London. She stayed with us, she came to London in 2008, I think 2009 it was. bands come to London, he sung with a group that I started over there as well. My brother, obviously, who I've been sung with my whole life. Lotte Latukefu from Tonga, the first Tongan international mezzo-soprano. I went to college with her.
I'm an OG.
Much of this is a family affair, with brother and bass baritone Eddie crediting Selinger for his career in opera.
I wouldn't have been singing in opera or theatre or anything if it wasn't for him. He was the one who encouraged me to come and audition with him. My background was I just played rugby.
In 87, I began my life in opera.
I'm a bass baritone because I have a serviceable top of my voice, which means I can do bass rolls and high bass rolls. A lot of bassists just do all the lower stuff. I can do the lower stuff and the sort of higher stuff. That's what bass baritone means.
And Uituilangi, having travelled from London to be here, has her parents who've come all the way from Perth.
I'm so thankful that they're here and they want to be here. You know, they really, when they heard that I was coming to do this, they were like determined to get here, so they booked their flights and everything. And just being here, oh my gosh, my dad's really mimika now because, you know, I thought he'd be really tired and now he's like watching everything. And it's, you know, their first time ever being in a rehearsal space, you know, to see how I work, you know. So it's quite special. Yeah, it's really special.
Most of this ensemble have travelled from Australia and the UK to be here for this one night of opera.
Just to be singing with Pacific Island opera singers who are at such a high level and our voices blending so much, but then also I never speak Tongan in Sydney where I live, but as soon as I come here it's like all this Tongan is coming out of my mouths in rehearsals and that sort of thing. It has truly been overwhelming. So just having these faces out there and representing and showing the world that Pacific Islanders are opera singers.
John, you should be in there.
Well, I am an OG. Thank you, Marama. And the concert is on tomorrow at Shared 10. Go to the Auckland Arts Festival page for the details.
And finally, our condolences go to the family of West Auckland educator and matriarch Toiole Sululaine Tipi, who died this week, among the pioneers of Pacific total immersion and bilingual education in West Auckland. She worked tirelessly to preserve the Samoan language, Manuia Lau Malanga.
Well, that's the end of our show. If you want to see any of the stories again or the latest Pacific news, go to tpplus.co.nz or TVNZ Plus.
Good luck to everyone at Auckland's Polyfest, Wananui in Dunedin, and also the Rotorua Pasifika Festival today.
Yes, have fun and have a great weekend. Aotearoa, koe kia.
Tangata Pasifika, born a people proud.